Hey guys, welcome back to Legend of Zelda, and we want to not go these ways. We want to go this way, yay! This way. We go this way. I feel like we already went this way. I don't know. Maybe not. So for this one, you want to make sure that you get the spike all the way away, because that is the spike to get. So what you want to do is, you want to be over here when you do this, because you have almost no time. Oof, that was really close. Wow. The compass. I love doing that. I'm weird. Uh-oh. Okay. That was good, because I would have landed right on those. You want to make sure you don't hit any of those, because they hurt. They are hurters. Yay, hurters. And now we want to go to the west end. We want to hurry up because of those spiders. They are a pain in the butt. Now what I like to do is we want to wait. I was about to say, if you can't hear it, this guy will jump on you and he'll knock you off this. And you don't want that. So, definitely don't encourage the spiders. They are mean spiders. They do mean things. Alright, so now we don't want Feroar's wind out. Well, we kind of do. What I'm going to do is put you over there. You remember, you gotta play Zelda's lullaby? You guys love Zelda's lullaby. This lifted all the way up, and we would proceed now, but I want to go back for that one key that we missed. So, let's head on down. We're going down, down. Oh my god, I can't believe I just said that. Oh no, people from my generation might know that song. If you don't know that song, then congratulations, you were saved the agony of my high school years. Fall Out Boy was very popular when I was a kid. And if you don't know who Fall Out Boy is, well, you're not missing much. Oh man, Fall Out Boy. Okay, so now we're gonna do the smart. Well, if you were smart, you would put Feroar's wind here just in case you made a mistake like I did, but I didn't do that. And I'll be okay now. Actually, you know what? We should put Feroar's wind because we will be coming back to this spot. But the key rule here is that Roar's wind will go to the nearest door. So go back out. Actually, it may stay. My bad. Let's see if it stays. Oh. Nope, see, it goes to the closest door. That's why I did that. Now, you could be all skillful and show-offy and use and use fire arrows to do this, but you know what? I'm not all skillful and show-offy. So I'm just gonna use Feroz Wind! And then open it. And not do that. Oh, hey, I used my thing! That was... I'm not gonna say it. I'm not gonna curse. I'm trying to, like, cut out the cursing. It's not good. Why is that every time... I ran this dungeon before doing this, and last time it shot me up looking at the ceiling. Why it does that? But anyways, we got a small key. La la la. And now I will meet you guys back at the top where we play the music towards the water again. So I'll see you guys in a minute.
All to Jesus I surrender all, to him I pray. I surrender all. I surrender all. All to him, my precious Savior. I surrender all. So here I am to worship. Here I am to bow down. Here I am to say that you're my God. Altogether lovely, altogether holy, altogether wonderful to me.
Okay, so now we want to play the song. And I don't want this guy to attack me, so I'm actually gonna let him come to me. Once he gets in the water, make a leap of faith. Turn around, he will come back. I suggest you go ahead and kill off these guys, because they will be a nuisance unless you know what you're doing. For us, though, we want to go this way. We won't encounter the other one right now, so we're fine. And... now, if you were smart, you would have gone and killed these guys. Without letting them come out at you. But I wasn't smart. And surprisingly, that wasn't a failure. Now, you'll hear it. There's a gold scutilla here. We can't do anything about him right now, so just ignore him and get down here. And don't move the camera in funky angles! Yeah. Nice job! Okay, well, I can show you the piece. Just normally. Ta-da! That's how you don't fail at life. Like me. Don't you want to fail at life like me? I don't think we can actually- yeah, we can't reach these unless we're down more. Hate that though, because this thing always makes me nervous. I always feel like I'm not close enough. Oh, don't like it. Now, You want to hurry up and do this, because if not, you won't get up fast enough, and me, I start freaking out. I'm like, oh my god, I'm not gonna make it, I'm not gonna make it. So don't freak out like I do. And eventually you will get up here, so don't worry too badly, I suppose. And this room's a pain just for the fact that you constantly have to be rising this water. I'm actually gonna take out my bow and kill this. Not do that, but kill this guy. There we go. Because he will try to come after you as soon as the water rises. And since you gotta use your hookshot here, it's just better. We do it like this. If you notice, I don't think I said anything last time, but I am using the big Goron sword because you don't see many keys in this place, which makes it good because you can kill these guys in one hit, which is what we kind of want to do. And the only reason why we had to bring the water down is because you have to climb over this guy. There is a target on him, but if you hit the target, he will drop you down and you'll have to do it all over again, so don't use his target. Don't use his targeting system! It doesn't work! It doesn't work, I tell you! But now, we still have to bring the water back down because... Well, you have to get on this guy's head, and then you have to hit it from here, which is even more fun. Or you could just miss, because that's what I do. I think you can hit that with a hookshot, I just never do, so it's like not in my DNA to react like that. This like, you can trick him out. See? Hee hee. Now he's dead, so you don't have to drop down on him. And you could actually, like, you know, target. What a con- Whoa. What a concept! That sounded so wrong because of that, at the spot where I stopped. Are you guys ready? It's mini boss time. Ow, I just elbowed the table. That was smart. So, usually, I thought that you actually had to walk all the way over there, but once you pass the tree, you'll be here. And this is your shadow self. Alright! Then come at me. Come at me, bro! There we go. If you try, I don't recommend using the Master Sword in this fight. It makes it like 10 times harder. There we go. Having a hard time getting stabs on him for some reason. And he's doing more. There we go. I get very impatient with this boss because he takes a lot of hits. And I'm like, okay, let's get it over with. So you'll see. I'll start to get impatient, and I'll start to swing wildly, and I'll just be, like, taking damage with him, just so that I can take him out quicker. It's bad. There we go. He's not that hard. And this is the cool part, watch. We are in a room. It was all an illusion. Yeah. I just think that's cool. And I think that area is cool because it reminds me of, what's that guy? Or, no, it reminds me of Twilight Princess in a weird way. So real quick, we'll go here and we'll get the item. We got the long shot. It's an upgraded hookshot. It extends twice as far. So yes, we got a new item, and it's very useful. We can hit things that are further away, as it said. So, with that, I Thank you all for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Peace out, everybody.